What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Suppose you are a software developer working for an insurance company. Now, to represent the clients of this company, what you did was create a class for each one based on the category this client belongs to. And because these clients share a few attributes, you went ahead and abstracted them into a parent class, the client class. Everything seems to be going smoothly, and you're very happy with your development, until your manager comes in and asks you to implement and add messaging functionality for the company, where, based on the type of the client that you have, a particular mail will be sent to that client informing them of new insurance deals. So, if it is a resident, a medical insurance ad will be sent. If it's a bank, a theft insurance mail will be sent, etc. At first, the job seemed pretty straightforward, and you planned to add a send mail method to the client class and override it in each specific child class. Then, all you had to do was bring in your list of clients and loop over each one of them while invoking the send mail method. The solution was simple and elegant thanks to polymorphism. However, if you take a closer look, you will notice that by doing what we did, we actually violated the single responsibility and open-closed principles. Our client classes started as plain old Java objects, but now contain actual functionalities that may break in the future, functionalities that may be calling third-party applications, like Outlook, for instance. Additionally, if we decide to change any functionality or alter our advertisement or mail behavior, we will need to open this piece of code and change it in each client class individually. So what we did is kind of something that allows us to extract all of these behaviors outside of the client classes on which they operate. One way to do that is by following the visitor design pattern. The visitor pattern is a behavioral design pattern that lets you separate algorithms or behaviors from the objects on which they operate. Let's try to apply it on our client's insurance example. To do that, I went ahead and created an insurance messaging visitor class alongside its visitor interface. Then I moved all of our messaging behaviors to that particular interface and added their implementations in the corresponding visitor class. But how exactly would we call these methods, especially when dealing with several clients? To pick the proper method, we'd need to check its class. Doesn't this sound like a nightmare? You might also ask, why don't we use method overloading? Go ahead and try to do that. Your code won't even compile and will ask you to cast the client object to one of its subclasses. You see, the exact class of a client object is unknown in advance, and hence the overloading mechanism won't be able to determine the correct method to execute. On the other hand, the visitor pattern addresses this by using a technique called double dispatch. Since the objects know their own classes, the main idea here is to delegate choosing the proper method to the object itself instead of letting the client select a method. So what each object will do is accept a visitor and tell it what visiting method should be executed. And while dealing with a list of clients, all you have to do is invoke this accept method alongside a visitor. Additionally, because we extracted all of these behaviors to a common interface, we can now easily introduce new visitors without altering existing ones. Okay, let's go ahead now and take a look at the structure or class diagram of the visitor pattern while trying to relate it to the insurance example we just implemented. The first thing you will be able to relate to is the visitor interface. The interface declares a set of visiting methods that can take concrete elements of an object structure as arguments. Next are the concrete visitors, which were represented by the Insurance Messaging Visitor class in our example. These classes implement several versions of the same behaviors, tailored for different concrete element classes. Speaking of which, the concrete element classes and the element interface you see in the diagram were represented by the different types of clients and by the client abstract class, respectively, in our insurance example. The element interface declares a method for accepting visitors. This method should have one parameter declared with the type of the visitor interface. To complement this, each concrete element must implement this acceptance method. The purpose of this method is to redirect the call to the proper visitor's methods corresponding to the current element class. Finally, the last piece of the diagram, as usual, is the client. The client represents or defines a collection or some other complex object and uses the visitor to invoke a certain behavior on each concrete element or part of this object. So, to sum everything up, the visitor design pattern lets you isolate particular behaviors from the objects on which they operate and places them in a single class. By doing this, the primary classes of your app will be more focused on their main job, so you will be enforcing the single responsibility principle. On top of this, by following the visitor pattern, you will be applying the open-closed principle because you now have the ability to introduce new visiting behaviors without modifying the existing ones. And these behaviors are now easily interchangeable by clients at runtime. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.